More now from 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue tonight. That's the president's close advisors are now talking about getting him to lawyer up. CNN's Jeff Zeleny has late word on that, joins us now. You've been digging in this. The president outside counsel, what do you know?
Well, Anderson, throughout the day, a small circle of advisors of the president have been talking about who they should hire for outside legal representation here. Michael Cohen, his personal lawyer, seen in the White House earlier today, having these meetings to talk about a strategy here going forward. I mean, this is an entirely new horizon they're about to happen here in Washington. A special prosecutor can look into everything, essentially. So what I'm told is a small circle of advisors says the president needs more firepower on the outside. So they are going to present a plan to him to hire some type of lawyers, a team of lawyers to help represent him in this going forward.
I mean, you know, plenty of legal scholars we've talked to say the president should absolutely do this, but are actually surprised he hasn't already.
That's a good question. I mean, the it's certainly typical for a president who's under this type of scrutiny and investigation to have someone from the outside, because the White House counsel's office, you know, is handling the work of his current job. This is about a private action, something that happened potentially during the presidential campaign. But, you know, we know President Trump is slow to sort of accept new people, new advisors. So he is being presented a plan of who he could trust here, and it's up to him to sign off on that. Some advisors want him to do so before he leaves Washington tomorrow. Unclear if he will do that or not. But of course, you know, the clock is running out here a little bit. But that's why there is a meeting today here at the White House. And, you know, they're presenting him this plan if they haven't already.
You know. All right. Jeff Zeleny, Jeff, thanks for that reporting. Today, as we mentioned at the top, Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein was on Capitol Hill briefing senators behind closed doors. Now, depending on which senators you ask, he also potentially said something that throws a monkey wrench into the White House explanation, at least the latest rationale for dismissing James Comey. Our Phil Mattingly has that, joins us now. So what have you learned about this closed-door meeting?
You know, it's interesting, Anderson. Depending on the senator, you heard largely deferential to Bob Mueller. He was careful. He was cautious, except on one issue specifically. Several senators came out and made very clear it was their understanding that Rod Rosenstein was aware that Jim Comey was going to be fired before he wrote the three-page memo that Trump administration officials have repeatedly cited as the reason. And as you noted, Anderson, the president himself cited as the reason for the firing today, even though the president has also cited another reason for the firing. Now, here's what I'm told actually happened. Mr. Rosenstein made very clear he was not pressured by the White House, but that he was aware the day before that the firing was likely to happen. Then he decided to write the memo. So it's very clear, Anderson, that kind of at the crux of where the White House has differed repeatedly on its story as to why this firing actually occurred and how this firing actually occurred, Rod Rosenstein was clearly aware before the memo was actually written. Here's what he didn't answer, though. Just about every other question related to the firing. I talked to a lot of Democratic senators who came out frustrated, thought that more answers should have been given. He will have another opportunity up on the Capitol Hill tomorrow while he briefs the House, but I'm told don't expect more to come from there. He's being very careful, especially given the appointment of the special counsel.
And what's been the congressional response to Mueller's appointment as special counsel?
Look, there's bipartisan praise for Bob Mueller. Obviously, most of the members up here worked with him when he was FBI director. His credentials are unimpeachable at this point. But there is actually concern, and that is there are multiple congressional probes going on, and there's a lot of concern as to what his separate investigation or his investigation as special counsel will do to those probes. Take a listen to what Lindsey Graham, a senator who is running one of those probes, had to say.
But the takeaway I have is that everything he said was that you need to treat this investigation as if it may be a criminal investigation. So I think the biggest legal change seems to be that Mr. Mueller is going to proceed forward with the idea of a criminal investigation versus a counterintelligence investigation.
And the senator's point here is this. They don't want to bump into a criminal investigation. They don't want to be subpoenaing documents that might get in the way of the congressional investigation. John Cornyn, who's on the Senate Intelligence Committee, a committee that's running its own investigation, said he believed this was the recipe for a train wreck. So what senators are trying to figure out right now, what leaders are trying to figure out right now, is how to kind of grasp onto a single point of contact. But leaders have been very clear, Anderson. They expect the congressional investigations to continue. They expect the committees to continue their work in spite of, or perhaps along with, Bob Mueller.
What does this mean for the congressional agenda moving forward? I mean, is it stalled?
Yeah, there's no question about it. Look, I asked Speaker Paul Ryan about this specifically today. I asked him, does all this drama essentially undercut what you're trying to do? And he said, look, the drama doesn't help, but we can walk and chew gum at the same time. And to a degree, that's true. Look, they've had hearings on tax reform. The House has passed an Obamacare repeal and replace. But the reality is, when you talk to Republican aides, at least that I've been speaking to over the course of the last couple of weeks, these are huge, ambitious items that they're trying to actually move through. And if you want to do that, you need the White House laser focused on those issues, outselling those issues, only talking about those issues. They simply haven't gotten that up to this point. And there's a lot of concern. While there's some relief on the short term about the special counsel being named, that all this is going to do is tie the White House up even more in the days, weeks, months, perhaps even years ahead. And frankly, that draws a lot of concern about those very ambitious agenda items that they had planned for 2017.
But all the congressional committees in Capitol Hill, on Congress and the Senate that are investigating, all those investigations will continue to move forward, regardless of Mueller.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And the leaders have made very clear that's exactly what they want. The Senate Intelligence Committee, both the chairman and the vice chairman, Democrat and Republican, have said their investigation will continue. The House Intelligence Committee actually requested the Comey memos today. And several, a total, Anderson, of four committees have requested those memos from Jim Comey over the course of the last couple of days. They have made very clear, Nancy Pelosi repeated again today, she wants Jim Comey to publicly testify. Anderson, I think the big question right now is, as this moves forward, twofold kind of, will anything run into anything else? Will these committees bang into one another? Will they get in the way of Bob Mueller as the FBI director, as the special counsel and what he's trying to do? And perhaps most importantly, are these investigations just going to be surface-based? At this point, will they essentially be undercut by everything that's going on, or will they actually come to a real conclusion? Yeah. I'm told, Anderson, that when you look at what the Senate Intelligence Committee is trying to do right now, think of it more as a counterintelligence investigation. That will be their focus. But again, it's an open question right now. They're kind of in uncharted territory right now.
Yeah, certainly seems that way. Full, thanks very much.